Well, between January and March, we usually see our cedar pollen season. It's also the time where cold, flu, and weather changes seem to make nasal symptoms, cough, sneezing, and other respiratory illnesses to be at their worst. So really, we try to have people prepare in the end of fall, at the beginning of the winter season, to be prepared for all of these things that may cause it to be a bad winter. So here in the Austin area, the Central Texas area, cedar pollen always is the dominant allergen, typically in January and February. It can start in the middle of December and in late December as well. It tends to dominate most of the people's symptoms as well as what most people fear most here in Central Texas. Mold also can be high, especially when the rains are how they have been in the recent few weeks. So those are the two big ones we see, but cedar always is the big worry for most people. So the differences between allergy and colds can be very difficult to tease out. Both will give you runny nose, congestion, sneezing. And so whenever these things occur during the winter, we try to tease those out by a few key symptoms. Number one is really being itchy. Itchy eyes, itchy nose, and sneezing attacks usually are earmarks of allergic reactions and allergic rhinitis. Response to antihistamines also is a key component to seeing changes with allergy that you're not going to see a whole lot of with colds. Colds tend to start quickly, progress after about 3 to 4 days, hit their peak, and then typically resolve over the next week or so. Allergies, however, will continue to be problematic as long as there's exposure. So as long as the cedar pollen counts are high, you're going to continue to have your itchy, runny, sneezy type symptoms. We tend to try to use other medications to help tease out what is what, but ultimately allergy testing may be necessary to help really tease out whether or not it is a cold or whether allergies are playing a role in your symptoms. Precautions that people should take to offset allergies include starting their medications at the earliest signs and symptoms that may occur. Hopefully, you have already started your allergy medications before the season started. That way, it will be prevented if the allergy symptoms do occur. So, starting antihistamines, starting nasal sprays and other allergy medications before the season generally is much more helpful than once the symptoms start. If symptoms start, however, it's important to get on those medications and to continue taking them throughout the rest of the season so that way that the inflammation won't build and symptoms will be well controlled. So treatment options for allergies are three basic things. Number one, we try to avoid the allergen. Number two, we use medications to treat allergy symptoms. And then number three is immunotherapy, allergy shots or allergy drops. So when we approach allergy seasons, we always try to take our medications before the season starts. Now, obviously, if you're in the middle of cedar pollen season or ragweed season or grass pollen season, then it may be too late. So what we try to do is start these medications early. Antihistamines can help with itchy, watery eyes, itchy, sneezy nasal symptoms. Nasal sprays tend to work best for nasal congestion, post-nasal drip, itchy symptoms as well. And there's a few other medications you can talk to your physician about as far as getting those symptoms under control.